Hi there guys, Tom Quayle here for Guitar Interactive Magazine, back again with another review, this time of a pick. Now, picks are generally pretty tricky to review because picks are very personal to guitar players. You know, everyone has their own preference of material they like to use, the size of pick they like to use. However, this is quite interesting. It's a little different to your average pick review, or your average pick product, I should say. This is the Talon pick, okay, Talon guitar pick. And this has got some very interesting features that we thought were worth kind of mentioning. So I've got three cameras set up. I've got one set up on my right hand here. I've got this camera just here where I can show the actual pick, and obviously got the wide shot. So we wanted to show you in detail what's going on with these picks. And they're basically designed with three different materials, with three different thicknesses. You've got your light, your medium, and your kind of hard or tougher material, heavy, as it's usually called. And then you've got four different models within each of those different thicknesses. Now, the four different models are labeled T1, T2, T3, T4. And the way they work, let me show you the pick. I've got the heavy version here, which is the red material. And if I show you on this camera here, there's the pick itself. Now you can probably see if I tilt it this way, that there's actually a bevel in here, like a sunken section. And this section here basically is where you would put your thumb. So when you hold the pick, you actually place your thumb in here, and then you've got the point of the pick sticking down. Let me see if I can get this in focus, it's a little tricky. So you've got the point of the pick sticking down, and your thumb sits inside this dugout bevel section. Okay, now the reason we've got T1, T2, and T3, and T4 is because this bevel section, this dip, gets thicker or fatter further down the further through the numbers we go. So T1, which is this pick here, it's got quite a shallow bevel, okay, or a shallow dip in it. Whereas T4, if I just grab that now, T4 has a much thicker, deeper dip in it. Okay, now the reason for this is the higher that number you actually pick with the with this section just here, this is the pick. You can actually pick with the standard, you can use it like a standard pick if you like as well, but you pick with this section, and the offset of this against the string gets bigger the deeper this dip is. Okay, so if we compare, there we go, you can probably see that now, hopefully this is a T4 and this is a T1, and you can see that the dip that you put your thumb in on the T4 is a lot deeper. Now, you might be wondering what that achieves. So the dip getting bigger between T1, T2, T3, and T4, well, the angle that your, as I say, the pick strikes the string at gets progressively more aggressive or more offset. And that gives you, the more offset that pick is against the string, you get a brighter and more aggressive attack. Okay, so the deeper your thumb sits in that groove, the more of the offset that you get. Now, within that, you've obviously got, for that T1, 2, 3, and 4, you've obviously got the three different strengths of pick. So, if I start, I'll let you hear what they sound like in a second, but let me grab one of each. So this is T4 of the light material. Let me show that to this camera over here. This is the light material, this kind of white material here that we've got. This mango-coloured one is the medium material, okay? Hopefully those are roughly in focus. And then the red one is our heavy, okay? Now, again, that follows the standard kind of pick mentality, which is that the thicker the pick is, the less it moves when you strike the string, and so you get kind of a bigger sound, and you know, you don't get so much of the click of the pick. But they're also slightly different materials, and they feel a little bit different in the hand. And I do have a sheet down here, which I'll read to you in a second, which tells you what each of those materials do, why they've been crafted that way. But there's a lot of research that's gone into these, and generally with a pick review, I would be very loath to kind of, you know, a pick is a pick, it's just a piece of plastic that strikes the string. But in this case, there's some interesting stuff going on here. So what I want to do, oh, by the way, really quickly as well, you can probably see just there that each of the picks has, oops, if I just get it in focus, has a textured grip as well, which means that as you've got your thumb in that divot, you know, the actual offset section, it's very, very sturdy. It's not going to go anywhere, even if you've got slightly sweaty fingers on stage. So that's quite good. There are a few things I don't like about the fact that the thumb sits in a divot, but I'll talk about those later. What I want to do first of all is I'm going to take the heavy pick, because that's what I would normally use, and I'm going to show you the difference between T1 and T4. So T1 for me is the most comfortable to play with if I'm using the Talon section, not the standard kind of pick section. Okay, now let me just show you really quickly what they sound like. So here's T1, and this has got the least On the most shallow kind of divot where your thumb sits in, and that means that it's got the least aggressive offset when you strike the string. So we get this, it's quite a mellow kind of sound. It's also pretty comfortable to play with because you're not sitting in a big kind of dip within the pick that kind of makes the pick part feel like it's higher up on the thumb, which is quite unusual. Because usually when you hold a pick, for all you guys who hold a pick like me, you'll hold it in between the thumb and the finger, and that means that the actual part of the pick that you pick with is in between, directly in between the thumb and the finger, whereas now it's offset slightly higher. Okay, so if I grab T4, the part that I pick with is actually quite high up on my thumb now. Now that takes quite a bit of getting used to. That's not particularly comfortable in the first instance, so it takes a little bit of getting used to. But what you do get, if I show you T1 again, that's a more mellow kind of sound. Now check out T4. Much more aggressive, much more kind of throaty high end as well, and you're hearing much, much more pick attack. And I'm going to leave a little bit of the mic sound in as well so that you can hear that pick attack coming through, because it's kind of useful to be able to hear that as well, so you can really hear what the pick's doing. Now, as I say, my biggest problem at this point is that that T4 is quite high up the thumb and feels a little strange to pick. So maybe you can see here when I'm actually picking, if you look at this camera over here, if I switch to this. I just pick kind of slowly. It does feel a little odd at first compared to the T1, which feels very natural because it's not as far up the thumb. This pick, the T1, I can quite comfortably pick. Whereas with the T4, I'm struggling a little bit. You can hear the attack is completely different, much more aggressive. And in between those, the T2 and the T4 give you the different shades of that pick attack. So as you get further towards T4, it's getting much more aggressive sounding as opposed to T1. So something to note there. I mean, generally a pick is not going to change your life, but this is actually the first time I've seen a range of picks that are the same design, a unique design in this case, where you can actually hear the tone changing the way that the person who's designed these picks is actually saying they're going to. So this actually fulfills the brief that the pick is designed to fulfill, which is pretty good, because often there can be a little bit of snake oil going on with picks. I mean, picks are picks, you know. They sound slightly different from one another, but they're not going to change your life as a guitar player. What will change your life is practice. However, this genuinely is affecting the way I can play as a musician, and is genuinely affecting the sound that I'm getting. So if I wanted a lot more attack, I could actually use the T4 picks or the T3. If I wanted a more mellow sound, I could use T2 and T1. So the other thing I'm going to do, I'm going to let you hear the difference between the different materials. So before I do that, let me put the other two down. Now, the sheet that I've got here, so I'm going to read what they've actually written in terms of the materials, what they should sound like. So the light material, which is the white kind of cream coloured material, crafted with a unique blend of materials to resonate a smooth, buttery tone and warmth, okay? With an ideal amount of flex, they provide a mild delivery to the strings and a soft release. Okay, now the medium ones, these are the mango ones, they're moulded with a superb material blend that offers a mid to bright tone, fast response and outstanding durability. With just a bit of flex, they bring a potent delivery to the strings with a quick release. This is their words, not ours. Heavy. Okay, so this is the red material. Injected with a sleek material blend that hits a bright tone, ultra fast response and apex durability. Not sure what that means. The string response is second to none, with a screaming fast release bred for attack. Okay, so what I would say is, if you understand how picks work, you don't need to worry about all that stuff. That's fine, sort of marketing spiel if you like, and that's all well and good. But basically, the light ones function as you'd expect a light pick to function. You get much less attack, and you get much more flex in the pick, if I just show you. Much more flex within the pick. And they're great for kind of strumming, which is a strange thing to do with this particular Talon section. So I tend to use the other side for this, and then I can choose where I hold the pick. The other problem I have with these picks, and again, they really fulfill the brief that they set out to do, so that's very positive. My other problem is I can't choose with this pick how far down I hold it, because this section where the thumb sits, again, try and get this in focus for you guys, this section where the thumb sits is set. So I put my thumb in there, and now I can't actually move my thumb further down the pick. So if I'm trying to do pinched harmonics, for instance, that's going to be an issue. Whereas if I use this end, this end here, okay, I can actually hold the pick as far down as I like, and I tend to have only about that much pick showing when I play. So that would be an issue for me. So, but the light version sounds great. Run my volume up a little bit because I've got a drive tone here. That feels superb. That would be great on an acoustic. Really good pick in that regard, actually. But it does kind of render the Talon bit a little bit pointless on this. But the as you move between the Talon, and back to the standard section of the pick. Having those two different attacks is very cool from a single pick. I just find for my playing that having to hold the pick in this way, being forced and told how to hold the pick, is a little bit of a problem for me. Okay, so that's how the light material sounds. Okay, let me grab the medium material, same pick, a T1. I'll use both ends of the pick, starting with the non-Talon part, which is this section just here. Okay, same thing. Getting a little bit more attack, less pick click, if you like. And if I turn around to the Talon side. Okay, and then finally, T1 on the heavy side of things, which you heard at the beginning. Okay, and then finally, I'm just going to go through the heavy pick using T1, T2, T3, T4, all the way through the range. Okay, and just imagine, you know, for each of the light and the medium, that if you did the same thing, you'd just get the similar kind of range, but obviously it would match the tone of each of those picks. And it's great. I can actually hear a big difference between the different materials. It's just that, again, that Talon is just a little bit problematic for me in terms of playing. You may find it absolutely superb, and I recommend if you can find these that you do actually give them a go, because you may find that this is a really, really useful thing for you, and you like the fact that the offset gives you different tones without having to angle the pick yourself to get different tones, which is quite useful. Okay, so T1, let's start out with T1, and I'm just gonna play a simple pentatonic scale. T2. Same pick. Okay, T3. Definitely more attack there, definitely a brighter sound, less kind of fullness to the sound. And then finally T4, which again I find quite awkward to play with. Okay, so there you go, you can hear that difference. It's really, really impressive that the actual pick does so specifically what they set out to do. Again, just to round up here, a pick's not going to change your playing. It's not going to suddenly make you sound great. It's not going to make an instrument that doesn't sound good suddenly. But this is a unique concept. I've never seen this before. And, you know, a unique concept within the pick world, well, that's quite hard to achieve. So they're very interesting. Okay, I can hear exactly what's going on with these picks. I can see exactly what the manufacturer and designer has gone for here, and I think they've very successfully achieved it. My personal kind of downsides, if you like, for me as a player, and I can only review as a personal kind of guitarist, is I don't like being told where to hold the pick. As I say here, I don't like the fact that I have to hold the pick there to use the Talon, and I can't go any further down. Now, I understand why that's the case, and also, if that is a problem, you can turn it round and use the other side. However, that then defeats the object of the offset of the Talon section of the pick. Apart from that, though, pretty impressed. I think these are, you know, a good product, a very nice innovation. Whether the pick world needed it, well, I'll let you decide that, guys. But you know, kind of interesting. They come in four packs, so you don't have to buy, if you don't want to, all the picks individually. So they do these four packs, which is kind of cool. Nice that they've thought about that and packaged them together, so you can find out which one you like. Or of course you can buy them individually as well, which is kind of cool. So this is what's called a Raptor pack. So as usual, guys, check out the full details in the text in the magazine. My name's Tom Quayle, and I will see you guys next time.